So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna do a really fun, super easy ragging. Just ragging. We wanna give this really nice texture through it. And yeah, I'm gonna walk you through all the steps. So let's get started.
Starting off with a base coat of Old White by Annie Salone. I'm gonna use a nice thick oval brush, and you definitely wanna have some water on hand when you're working with chalk paint. To avoid the paint gathering and clumping at your drawer fronts, it's really good to pull those out. This is just the base coat. We're probably going to need a couple with such a dark finish and dark wood. I really, really wanted to salvage these hardware pieces, but unfortunately I could not remove them. So to remedy the situation, I will show you exactly what I can do to bring these back to a metal look. I have a feeling I'm going to have to put at least two, maybe three coats on because I'm using a very, very strong white color on a dark color wood. And having said that, I want lots and lots of texture. So good random brush strokes, lots of cross hatching, and you're going to see why as we continue, why I want lots of texture. Moving on to my second coat. You can actually start to use a little less paint. You really just are trying to gather into areas that seem a little bit faded, and you're just building up a nice strong finish of white. So this is where that water bottle will definitely come in handy when you're moving your paint around. Again, for your second coat, you're not really using a lot of paint. You just want that water to move it around and give a much more smoother white finish. And again, you definitely want to pull those drawers out so your paint doesn't gather. And you want to have a nice continuity finish when you're completing your piece. So this is where it is really important to make sure you're doing that cross hatching, as well as moving that brush around really, really random. You want lots and lots of texture. And again, you're going to see why we want this texture as we get into the next step and technique. So we're going to move on to the next technique, but it's really important to make sure that these base coats are fully dry. And you're going to use some rags. I'm using shop towels, which work well too, and I want a dry one and a wet one. Also recommend to have a couple of dry and a couple of wet towels available. We're going to start with a paint wash in graphite, which is a black chalk paint, and it's a 50-50 mix. All I'm going to do with a chip brush is I'm just going to wash this table with this black wash chalk paint. No specific brush stroke. It's on a horizontal angle. You just really want to get the wash on there, and you're going to see our next effect of what we're going to do. And I'm going to be using both dry and wet towel. The dry is going to pick up excess moisture that I've applied with the wash, and the wet towel is going to help me move it around to add the texture. This will all make sense as we continue on. Again, really important to have a few wet towels and a few dry towels on hand because they will get saturated as we continue as well. And have some fun with this. Play with it. Add some more wash. Play around with the texture that you're getting. And there's really no limits with this at all. And it just makes such a beautiful, beautiful texture finished. Sometimes, again, it can be very helpful to do this into quadrants, but at the same time, have fun with the movement of the rag. Flip the rag around. You want to bring it up and push it down, and this is going to create all kinds of different textured looks the more you move that rag around. As we move from this horizontal position and get down to the drawers into vertical, I'm going to show you a few tricks that I do so that way you don't have too much of a mess and run off with your wash. Making sure that you get into the frame versus the drawers, I suggest doing them separately. So I'm going to go ahead and do this first drawer. And what I find is making sure that my brush is actually not too saturated with water. And this is going to give you a little bit more control so there's not too much runoff, considering we're on a vertical angle now. And then you can, again, always add a little bit more of this black wash if you want a deeper texture tone with your color choice. Once my wash is applied, I generally use the drier rag and then move to the moist rag. And this helps play with the levels of tone that's being left behind with the wash. Again, it's all just for fun. Have fun with this. Use any chalk paint brand that you like. Use any chalk paint color tones. You can have so much fun and create such beautiful finishes with this technique. Once I've done the drawer front, I usually open the drawer and just do around the frame just for the continuity, and so that way the actual textured finish will match. So moving on to the second drawer, what you want to do is make sure that your brush is moist, but not too moist. So just give it a little bit of a brush off of your chalk paint container that you've made of your wash, and try not to add too much at once, and go ahead and grab that dry towel and give that a wipe. The biggest thing that I can mention when I first started doing this is that tapping motion is what really gives that true definitive texture. Not so much the wipe, it's the tapping when I do the ragging effect. And if for any reason you feel like you've actually taken off too much depth with the contrast color, go ahead and put some more wash on there, grab your rags, and keep going until you love it. How you decide you want to define your texture to be light, or if you'd like to go with a more bold texture, that is completely up to you, depending on your furniture, your color, and your preference. Again, this is a very forgiving technique and leaves such a beautiful old world nostalgic look. It's probably my favorite technique. Also, if you wanted to add another color, I'm only using the base white and the black, but if you wanted to add another color wash, by all means, you're going to add even more depth and more color perception within your ragging technique. So that's always a great option as well. But this is a great demo to show just using the two contrasted color tones. Because I'm on that vertical angle, if you need to go back and add a little bit more of that chalk paint wash, by all means, you can do this a couple of times as you're creating your depths. So that's exactly what I'm doing. I go around, I've placed it on, and I want it to be a little bit thicker and richer, add some more dimension in a few areas. Sky's the limits. Don't be afraid. What's the worst that's going to happen? If you don't like it, go back to your base, try something else, try something new. I have never been disappointed with this technique. I really feel the organic old world look that it gives is absolutely beautiful in all my experience. I have decided to do a stencil frame on the tabletop, and I'm going to use my chalk paint washes, as well as I think I'm even going to add a little bit of some bluey blue. And just using those artist brush, I'm just going to give a little bit of a tap, 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 and I am going to go ahead and see how this stenciling might look with this finish. And let's see how that turns out. The most important rule with stenciling is using very little paint. You're better to go back and add rather than have too much, because what happens is it will get underneath the stencil. So you want to just use a little bit at a time. So as we continue, I'm going to show you the effects that I want to do with giving this more of an aged look as well. The colors are being applied very random. I don't have a particular pattern. I just want a little bit of blue, maybe even a little bit of this French linen and a little bit of that graphite in there. Again, you can pick any colors you like, and I just want to go around and make a nice even frame all around this tabletop. And I'm going to show you how I lightly fade all of this stenciling so it looks like it's part of the faded look with the original wash as we continue. So let's take a quick aerial on how this is all coming together. I am truly loving the result. So to fade this out, I've decided to make a white wash using the same base color we originally had. So just with a wash, I'm just going to go ahead and apply that. But again, really important that your stencil is 100% dry before you go and put your wash on there. And what this is going to do is it's going to dilute all that stenciling that we originally did. And starting with the base, I'm going to go ahead and do this all over the tabletop. Once this wash is completely dry, I'm actually going to go ahead and do another black chalk paint wash to the tabletop. And this is what's going to complete that beautiful faded look for the stencil. So now that you can see, we can match it all back up to how we originally had it before we even stenciled. So again, just adding your base coat and your original wash gives you a beautiful stencil faded look. Always remember, if you feel your wash was too dark or too light, just grab the opponent color that you were using and keep playing with it until you like it. It is so forgiving, and this is where chalk paint is so much fun. So I want to show you guys how I'm going to remedy the hardware. And here I'm using a liquid wax, black wax, and a metallic umber. And what I want to do is just with a little tiny artist brush, I am literally just going to hand paint on both the umber, which is a metallic paint, and then I'm going to mute it with the black wax, and it's going to give it a nice old worn look, but make it look like the metal hardware again. The liquid wax I'm using is just because I'd like to make it more aged, but that's a total option. You don't have to do that, and you can pick any metallic paint you like. Because the hardware was actually nailed and glued onto this piece, this is a great way to remedy a situation where you've had to paint over the hardware. There are so many different metal color tones that you can pick, from gold to silver. I'm just using umber. The other thing that's also a beautiful effect is going to be a gliding wax, which I'm going to introduce to you next. Again, have some fun, put some sparkle, do whatever you like based on your own personal preferences. I have wanted to try rose gold for quite some time, so I'm going to go ahead and give that a go. So again, just with your fingertips, it's super easy to apply gilding wax. And again, they come in many, many different shades. So pick the preference that you like and go ahead and apply it. If for any reason you feel like it may be a little too much or you don't even like it, you can grab some clear wax and actually pull back the gilding wax. That's the beautiful control about using gilding wax. All of the products that I've used for this project will be in the description box below for your own purchase and or for reference based on what you have at home. Here's a quick shot of what it looks like with painted hardware versus using metallic and gilding wax. So it does really make a big difference.
If you like this tutorial, don't forget to give me a thumbs up. And if you have any questions at all, please feel free to leave me a comment in the comment box below. I'd love to hear from you. As well as don't forget to subscribe.